They asked me if I was seeing someone else.
Were you?
I didn't want to say anything in front of her boss, the one that was like passive aggressive about everything. And there was somebody else. So what happened with Brittany is extremely awkward. Things went very poorly at her lunch with her little manager. The most disappointing part of it was how Brittany orchestrated it. So I blocked her on social media, I blocked her number. I didn't want anything to do with her. I think there's nothing more to pursue with her.
Hey, what's up with you?
A lot, actually.
Matt told me what happened with Brittany, and I did tell Matthew that Brittany is not the one for him, but he is upset. I need to talk to my son. You gonna let it breathe or no?
That's the point. What's
That's
the point?
True.
Yep.
Well?
You know, I lost my cool. She asked me if I was seeing someone else.
Were you?
I didn't want to say anything in front of her boss, the one that was like passive aggressive about everything. And there was somebody else.
Well, why?
But I should have said the truth.
Because that's a hard pill to swallow, isn't it?
Yeah. So I took a coward way out and I didn't say anything. And I admit.
Well.
But I didn't cheat on her. She was never my girlfriend, but that's where I didn't communicate anything.
Stop. You should feel bad. You want to be the better person. I'm very disappointed. I didn't raise a cheater. I didn't raise someone not to be kind in relationships. Matt, I didn't like Brittany for you anyway. I knew she wasn't the one for you. That doesn't mean I didn't like Brittany. It is not right to mislead, to lie, to be dishonest. You know, think of it this way. You have a daughter. Would you want that to happen to your daughter?
No.
No. He was in a long relationship, pretty tumultuous, and I think this is normal, what he's going through. He doesn't know it because he hasn't lived through it. He's going to have just the girls that are there for a little bit, but he is going to find the right one. That's just the way life is.
I was so caught off guard, and I didn't know what to say, and... I don't even know.
Take my advice and apologize. Matt has a lot to learn in the dating world, but that's why I'm here. I'm supposed to steer him back in the straight direction. So who is this mystery woman?
Her name is Devin.
Devin?
We met back in 2019, and then I ran into her at the gym. She's older.
Hmm.
I think that I have held back telling my mom about Devin because I've needed to take a little bit of space. She has two teenagers.
Oh boy. I don't know if I'm ready. If it were up to me, Matt wouldn't be dating right now. He needs some time to reflect and be alone.
She's probably the kindest person I've ever met.
Kinder than me?
Nobody's kinder than you.
All right, thank you.
She makes me happy. I can't see myself waiting more than a year to propose.
What?
I already know her ring size. I already know the ring she likes.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm a little worried because he's kind of acting out. Given what he's gone through, the big relationship, the rebound, I think Matt needs to take this maybe a little bit slower and at least introduce her to the family before he starts looking at ring sizes. It bothers me that I haven't met her yet. What's he hiding? Don't you feel it's kind of going a little fast?
If I'm happy, who cares? I mean, it shouldn't matter.
This is like a whirlwind.
Okay, I know.
Woo!
But you know what? Everyone's gonna have an opinion about this. I can care less. I think for the first time, I don't care.
If I don't have the approval from my mom, that's okay. You know what? I'm excited. I'm excited for, you know, my future again.
I want Matt to find love. We all want love, but not in this way. It feels like it's being rushed, forced, and there's teenagers involved. But I don't know if there's any stopping him. I'm always here to talk for any advice. Just take it slow.